Hi guys, my name is Nishil Kaushal and I'm currently interning with the Lexlation company, and today I will talk about what is sociology and what are the aims and scopes of sociology. So I'll start. So basically, the works which deals with the social life, social change and the social causes and consequence of human behavior is called sociology. Who studies on this are called sociologists. He investigates the structure of groups, organizations and societies and how people interact within these contexts. Since all human behavior is social, the subject matter of sociology ranges all activities of the human being. In fact, few fields have such broad scope and relevance of research, theory and application of knowledge. It provides the distinctive perspectives of the world, generating new ideas and analyzing the old. It is a field which offers a range of research techniques. It can be applied to virtually any aspect of social life. Socially addresses the most challenging issues of our time. It is expanding the field whose potential is increasingly tapped by those who construct policies and create programs. Sociologists understand social inequality, patterns of behavior, forces of social change and resistance, and how social systems work. As a sociology, it is an exciting discipline with expanding opportunities for a wide range of career paths. The definition of sociology is also very vast and cannot be confined into a single objective. So basically, what are the aims of sociology? So basically, sociology studies the activities from primitive period to till date of the human being. The analysis has origins in the common stock of Western knowledge and philosophy. It has been carried out from as far as the back of the Plato of the Greek philosopher. The origin of the survey, that is the collection of the information from a sample of individuals, can be tracked back to at least the Doomsday Book in 1086. The ancient philosopher such as Confucius wrote about the importance of social roles. There is good evidence of the early sociology in medieval period. Some sources consider Ibn Khaldun, a 14th century Arab Islamic scholar from North America, Tunisia, to have been the first sociologist and father of sociology. The Muqaddima was perhaps the first work to advance social scientific reasoning on social coercion and social conflict. After the French Revolution, it is proposed that the social ills can be remedied through sociological positivism, an approach outlined in the course of positive philosophy and a general view of positivism. Comte believed a positive stage could mark the final era after congenital theological and metaphysical phases. He may be regarded as the first philosopher of science in the modern sense of the term in the progression of human understanding. He has studied the circular dependence of theory and observation in science. Now, what are the scope of sociology? So basically, the scope of sociology means the subject matter or the areas of studies on social life. Every science has its own field of inquiry. It becomes difficult to study a science systematically unless its boundary or its scope is determined precisely. But there is a lack of one opinion on this subject. There is a good ideal of controversy about the scope of sociology. Some supporters believe that sociology is a specific science and the scope should be limited, whereas others believe that it is a general science and its scope is very vast. However, sociology as a social science has its own scope or boundaries. In 1939, Auguste Comte, a French philosopher, marked the term sociology. It is the youngest of all social sciences. Sociology is the outcome of man's research for a more valid and precise knowledge about the nature of man and society. The etymological meaning of sociology is the science of society. So it can say that sociology is the study of man's behavior in groups. It interacts among human beings of social relationships. The process are dealing the activities of human group. Again, sociologists alone does not study the forms of social relationships. Other social scientists also do that. Further, the distinction between the forms of social relations and their contents is not practicable. So the formalistic study has narrowed down the scope of sociology in all aspects. Thank you.